The Rio Grande is an important part of the history, culture, and environment of New Mexico. Now, one pueblo along the river has been working for decades to restore the landscape to a more natural state and bring back wildlife that once called the area home. Correspondent Laura Paskus takes us to the pueblo of Santa Ana this week for the latest installment of Our Land, New Mexico's Environmental Past, Present, and Future.
The pueblo of Santa Ana sits next to the Rio Grande, north of Albuquerque and Rio Rancho. For nearly 900 tribal members, the land is not only home, but an important place that connects them to their ancestors.
The river has always been important to us culturally for the pueblos and for Santa Ana. We have traditional dances, grandparents, parents tell you, and they tie in with it, the ecological system as a whole for the reason why we're doing it.
Governor Montoya says protecting medicinal plants and culturally significant areas and wildlife is important for the tribe, and that others in New Mexico can see the work they're doing when they visit the pueblo for events or recreation.
I think a lot of people, no matter ethnicity, people like to see the bosque in its state that it was.
The tribe has been working to restore the bosque and the Rio Grande for decades, but far from the riverbanks, there's even more work being done. The tribe's Natural Resources Department is restoring turkey populations, trying to help endangered fish and birds, and tracking mountain lions and bears. They've also worked on restoring healthy fire to the landscape and install water features for wildlife. And in 2005, the Tribal Council created a wildlife conservation code. This vision was created by tribal leaders for the benefit of everyone living at Santa Ana. Part of the work is thinning out trees and returning lands to what they once were before colonization and livestock grazing.
It's pretty intense, this work. And you have to be out here in the winter and the hot summer, cold. It's just all noxious weeds that are out here, so we try to bring all the grasslands back to what it was back before. When we cut the trees and throw the slash down, then it's not so hot when you put down fire. It brings back all the grasses. I like being out in the outdoors, and it's a good job for me, and it's close to home. I don't have to deal with traffic.
Most parts of Santa Ana Pueblo are off limits to non-tribal members unless invited. In parts of the pueblo's 79,000 acres, pronghorn have been reintroduced after nearly 40 years of being missing from the area.
There used to be antelope up here on the mesa. This is Santa Ana Mesa. And there used to be antelope along Highway 550. It was coming kind of this periphery herd that would come from the Rio Rancho area. Bringing them back was something that the council requested.
The Santa Ana Pueblo Natural Resources Department worked with state and federal officials to gain permits and funding to bring in about 100 pronghorn. They started releasing the animals in 2009. Not all survived. Some were eaten by predators, and a few died from the stress of being moved. Others traveled beyond the borders of the pueblo. There are currently about 70 pronghorn on the pueblo, and the department is also following mountain lions and other predators that are outfitted with GPS collars.
We'll be able to look at what kind of impact are they having, how many animals are they killing on the pueblo, and what species. We're also looking for travel corridors. Are these large carnivores moving on and off the pueblo, and if so, where are they moving, so that we can try to protect those areas and provide connectivity for wildlife in this area. I think they're off in that direction over there. You want to look?
Glenn Harper has worked for the tribe for nearly 20 years. He says a changing climate and new challenges will test the groundwork that's already been laid for wildlife and people.
Tribal Council has been a leader, in the Rio Grande Valley, in supporting restoration work on their land, knowing full well that there's pressures from the outside, you know, Rio Rancho, Bernalillo, Placidas, just expanding communities, land use like mining, water issues with the lack of water. And so they know full well that in order to maintain their cultural identity, they have to protect their land.
For Our Land in New Mexico in Focus, I'm Laura Paskus.